I'm joined now by Rhone Resch. He's president of the Solar Energy Industries Association. Rhone, it's great to see you again.
Thank you, Steve. It's good to be here.
Certainly a joyous mood here at the conference. After 2 years of trying to get the investment tax credit passed, a long-term extension, we finally have an 8-year extension of the ITC.
And we couldn't be happier. Absolutely excited. This is a fundamental game changer for the solar energy industry. For the first time, literally in a generation, the industry has policy certainty. We have a level playing field with the oil and gas industry, with the nuclear and clean coal industries, and now we can grow in this country knowing that we're going to have a market for solar for the next decade.
Mm-hmm. And put it into context with regard to this conference. This is a chance for us to reflect on the good and bad in the industry over the year. What are you hearing from people at the conference as you walk around?
Well, I'll tell you, I really wasn't looking forward to this conference about 2 weeks ago before we passed the tax credit, simply because the looming expiration at the end of the year meant that a lot of these businesses were laying people off and that sales were down. But with the passage just 10 days ago, all of a sudden there's an entire new level of energy. Companies are signing deals today and throughout the entire week. The entire career center has been packed with people, lots of new jobs on the table. And we're really seeing the solar industry continue to the boom that we've undergone for the last several years. We've become an economic engine in this country, and we're seeing that here this week and in San Diego.
Well, characterize the last 2 years. You have worked tirelessly to get this tax credit passed. How has it been working on Capitol Hill? There's been a lot of partisan bickering over how we pay for these tax credits. What's been the political situation in Washington, and how did you make your way through it?
During the 110th Congress, the last 2 years, it's been absolutely brutal. The Democrats and the Republicans were on opposite sides of issues. There was very little coordination in trying to pass legislation. And so both in the House and the Senate, we found it very difficult to actually get our legislation passed. I mean, people think solar energy tax credits, wind tax credits, that's a no-brainer. That's exactly what the public wants. It's exactly what our communities need in this country.
And both sides of the aisle supported extending those credits.
That's exactly right. But it was partisan politics that got in the way. In the Senate, we had 7 filibusters, 2 of which we lost by 1 vote. Very, very frustrating process. And in the House, we had an additional 7 votes that took place. Over the course of the last 21 months, we had a total of 17 votes that it took until we finally passed the tax credits. And this is something that the entire industry lived through almost on a weekly basis, because we had a very coordinated effort where our entire industry were writing to members of Congress, they were calling members of Congress, they're participating in fundraisers, they're inviting members out to ribbon cuttings. And you know, at the end of the day, to have those continuous setbacks was exhausting. And so when it was finally attached to the Economic Stabilization Act at the end of September, then signed into law in the beginning of October, I think there was a great sense of relief from the industry.
Absolutely. And then part of the push was economic progress, job creation. Tell me about how you really latched on to that theme and pushed that forward in Congress.
There was two fundamental studies that we did through the Solar Energy Research and Education Foundation, these two studies funded by the Energy Foundation. And they were to look at what happens if the tax credit expires. That was the first study that we did back in February. And that study showed that the solar industry alone would lose 39,000 jobs in the next year and about $8 billion of economic investment. What that showed is that solar was going from being an economic engine to being another industry on the unemployment lines. Congress really did respond to that. And so what happened very quickly was a series of bills that supported us but never finally got through. What we then did is to look at, okay, what happens if we get a long-term tax credit extension? If we get 8 years, what is this going to do for the country? And again, the Energy Foundation study showed that we would create, just solar alone, over 440,000 new jobs in the U.S. and 1.2 million new job starts. Perhaps more important, Stephen, is that we would generate over $320 billion of new economic investment in the solar industry. Once we had those numbers on the table, it was impossible for the Senate and for the House to turn their back on solar. And it became very clear that we were going to be the only industry to get a substantial extension in any bill that was going to go forward.
So it seems fitting that it would be in this bailout package. While the overall context is negative, what we're trying to do here is boost the economy, and solar plays an important role in that.
Well, you know, I'm sad it actually took so long for us to actually get it passed, and that it finally had to be in the last bill, effectively, that Congress enacted before they left. But it's important to note that we were in every major economic legislation introduced in the 110th Congress, from the housing bill to the Defense Reauthorization Act to to the economic stimulus bill and so many others. We were in each bill, but effectively got rejected right at the last minute. So to have us pass in this bill, we're very happy.